problem? First of all, I'm a rat. Which means life is hard. And second, I have a highly developed sense of taste and smell. Flour, eggs, sugar, vanilla bean. Oh, small twist of lemon.
Oh, you can smell all that? You have a gift.
This is Emil, my brother. He's easily impressed.
Oh, you can smell ingredients. So what?
This is my dad. He's never impressed. He also happens to be the leader of our clan. So what's wrong with having highly developed senses? Whoa, don't do that!
What's going on here?
Turns out that funny smell was rat poison. Suddenly Dad didn't think my talent was useless. I was feeling pretty good about my gift. Until Dad gave me a job. Clean. That's right. Cleanerific poison checker. Cleanery new. Close to godliness. Which means clean. Yeah, cleanliness is close to... Never mind. But, well, it made my dad proud.
Now, don't you feel better, Remy? Dad, you've helped a noble cause.
Noble? We're thieves, Dad. And what we're stealing is, let's face it, garbage.
It isn't stealing if no one wants it.
If no one wants it, why are we stealing it? Let's just say we have different points of view. This much I do. If you bar what you eat, then I only want to eat the good stuff. But to my dad...
Food is fuel. Get picky about what you put in the tank. Your engine is gonna die. Now shut up and eat your garbage.
If we're going to be thieves, why not steal the good stuff in the kitchen? Where nothing is poison.
First of all, we are not thieves. Secondly, stay out of the kitchen and away from the humans. It's dangerous.
I know I'm supposed to hate humans, but there's something about them. They don't just survive. They discover. They create. I mean, just look at what they do with food.
How can I describe it? Good food is like music you can taste. Color you can smell. There is excellence all around you. You need only be aware to stop and savor it.
Right. Oh, yeah. Oh, amazing. Each flavor was totally unique. But combine one flavor with another, and something new was created. So now, I had a secret life. Who knew about it was Emil. Hey, Emil, I found a mushroom. Come on, you're good at hiding food. Help me find a good place to put this.
He doesn't understand me, but I can beat myself around him.
Why are you walking like that?
I don't want to constantly have to wash my paws. Did you ever think about how we walk on the same paws that we handle food with? You ever think about what we put into our mouths?
All the time.
When I eat, I don't want to taste everywhere my paws have been.
Well, go ahead. But if Dad sees you walking like that, he's not gonna like it.
What have you got there? Oh. You found cheese? And not just any cheese. Tome de chèvre de pain! That would go beautifully with my mushroom! And this rosemary! This rosemary, with a few drops from this sweet grass!
Well, throw it on the pile, I guess, and then we'll go.
We don't want to throw this in with the garbage! This is special.
But we're supposed to return to the colony before sundown, or, you know, Dad's gonna...
Emil! There are possibilities unexplored here. We gotta cook this! Now, exactly how we cook this is the real question. Yeah!
Maybe we shouldn't be so...
time she turns on the cooking channel, boom, she never wakes up.
You've been here a million times?
I'm telling you, Saffron will be just the thing. Gusteau swears by it.
Okay, who's Gusteau?
Just the greatest chef in the world. Wrote this cookbook.
Wait. You read?
Well, not excessively.
Oh, man, does Dad know?
You could fill a book, a lot of books, with things Dad doesn't know. And they have, which is why I read, which is also our secret.
I don't like secrets. All this cooking and reading and TV watching while we read and cook. It's like you're involving me in crime, and I let you. Why do I let you?
What's taking those kids so long?
Aquila Saffron. Italian, huh? Stowe says it's excellent. And then the old lady is a food alone.
Stars after scathing review by Francis Stubb, food critic.
I've just lost my family. All my friends. Probably forever.
What the hell do you know?
Well, I... You are an illustration. Why am I talking to you?
You're useless, your family. All your friends. You are lonely.
Yeah, well, you're dead.
But that is no match for wishful thinking. If you focus on what you've left behind, you will never be able to see what lies ahead. Now go up and look around.
Chef.
Up that
of the world. Who is that?
Oh, him? He's nobody.
Not nobody. He is part of the kitchen.
Now he's a plumber or something. He washes dishes or takes out the garbage. He doesn't cook.
He could.
No.
How do you know? What do I always say? Anyone can cook.
Well, yeah, anyone can. That doesn't mean that anyone should.
Well, that is not stopping him. See?
It was not a customer. It was a critic.
Ego?
Sorry, Leclerc.
Leclerc? What does she say?
She likes a soup.
What do you mean, wait? You're the reason I'm in this mess.
Stop talking about your soup.
What are you playing at?
Am I still fired?
You can't fire him.
What?
Leclerc likes it, yeah? She made a point of telling you so. If she write a review to that effect and find out you fired the cook responsible...
He's a garbage boy.
Who made something she liked? How can we claim to represent the name of Gusto if we don't uphold his most cherished belief?
And what belief is that, Mademoiselle Batou?
Anyone can cook.
Perhaps I have been a bit harsh on our new garbage boy. He has taken a bold risk, and we should reward that, as Chef Gusto would have. If he wishes to swim in dangerous waters, who are we to deny him?
You were escaping?
Oh, yeah. Since you have expressed such an interest in his cooking career, you should be responsible for it. Then back to work! You are either very lucky or very unlucky. You will make the soup again. And this time, I'll be paying attention. Very close attention. They think you might be a cook. But you know what I think, Linguini? I think you are a sneaky, overreaching little...
be worse. There's heat and light and a couch for the TV, so, you know, what's mine is yours.
Are you... Is this a dream?
It's the best kind of dream. One that we can share.
But why here? Why now?
Why not here? Why not now? What better place to dream than in Paris? Yeah!
want you to know how honored I am to be studying under such...
No, you listen. You don't know exactly who you are dealing with. How many women do you see in this kitchen?
Well, I...
Only me. Why do you think that is?
Well, I...
Because Hot Wazine is an antiquated hierarchy built upon rules written by stupid old men who've designed to make it impossible for women to enter this world. But still, I'm here. How did this happen?
Because you...
Because I'm the toughest cook in this kitchen. I worked too hard for too long to get here, and I'm not going to jeopardize it for some garbage boy who got lucky. Got it?
Sure.
a major corporation.
I robbed the second largest bank in France using only a ballpoint pen. I created a hole in the ozone of Ravignon. I killed the man with this dump. not your dog. Oh, seriously, no. I loved when a little dog was you, linguine, in my office.
Am I in trouble?
Trouble? No. A little wine, a friendly chat, just us.
The project won't be coming to you for advice anymore, Ecola. He's gotten all he needs.
Toasting your success, eh, Linguini? Good for you.
Oh, I just took it to be polite. I don't really drink, you know.
Of course you don't. I wouldn't either if I was drinking that. But you would have to be an idiot of elephantine proportions not to appreciate this 61 Chateau Latour. And you, Monsieur Linguini, are no idiot. Let us toast your non-idiocy.
Thank you.
someone to replace you, but Poison Checker has been a disaster. Nothing's been poisoned, thank God, but it hasn't been easy. You didn't make it easy.
I know. I am sorry, Dad.
Well, the important thing is that you're home.
Yeah, well, about that.
You look thin. What is that? A shortage of food or a surplus of snobbery? Yeah. It's tough out there in a big world all alone, isn't it?
Sure, but it's not like I'm a janitor,
right?
I can take care of myself. I found a nice spot not far away, so I'll be able to visit on.
Nothing like a cold flash of reality to make you visit?
I will, I promise. Often.
Well, you're not staying?
No, it's not a big deal, Dad. You didn't think I was going to stay forever, did you? Eventually a bird's got to leave the nest.
We're not birds. We're rats. We don't leave our nests. We make them bigger.
Well, maybe I'm a different kind of rat.
Maybe you're not a rat at all.
Maybe that's a good thing.
Hey, the band's really on tonight, huh?
Rats. All we do is take, Dad. I'm tired of taking. I want to make things. I want to add something to this world.
You're talking like a human.
You are not as bad as you say.
Oh, yeah? What makes you so sure?
This is...
personal relationship with the chef. Oh, I see how it is. You give me to teach you a few kitchen tricks to dazzle the boss and then you block out me.
Wake up.
You were different. I thought you thought I was different.
Closing, is it?
No.
Or financial trouble?
No, it's...
Announce a new line of microwave egg rolls. What? Spit it out.
It's... Come back. It's popular.
I haven't reviewed Gusto's in years.
No, sir.
My last review condemned it to the tourist trade.
Yes, sir.
I said, Gusto has finally found his rightful place in history right alongside another equally famous chef. Monsieur Boyardee.
Touché.
That is where I left it. That was my last word. The last word.
Yes.
Then tell me, Ambrister, how would it be popular?
No.
Is it any matches? The timing works. Everything checks out.
He is Gusto's son.
This can't just happen. The whole thing is a setup. The boy knows.
String?
Yes, playing dumb, taunting me with that rat.
Rat?
Yes, he's consorting with it, deliberately trying to make me think it's important.
The rat?
Exactly.
Is the rat important?
Of course not. He just wants me to think that it is.
Oh, I see the theatricality of it. Rat appears on the boy's first night. I order him to kill it, and now he wants me to see it everywhere.
Oh, it's here. No, it isn't. It's here. Am I seeing things? Am I crazy? Is there a phantom right or is there not? But, oh, no, I refuse to be sucked into his little game of...
Should I be concerned about this? About you?
attention. If I fire him now, everyone will wonder why. And the last thing I want is people looking into this.
What are you so worried about? Isn't it good to have the press? Isn't it good to have Gusto's name getting headlines?
Not that they're all about his face! Gusto's already has a face, and it's fat and lovable and familiar. And it sells burritos! Millions and millions of burritos!
The deadline passes in 3 days. Zed, you can fire him whenever he ceases to be valuable. I was worried about the hair sample you gave me. I had to send them back to the lab.
Why?
Because the first time it came back identified as rodent hair.
I was reminded how fragile it all was, how the world really saw me, and it just kept getting better.
Remy!
Hey, little brother! We were afraid you weren't gonna, you know, show up.
Hey, Remy, how you doing?
You know what you told them? Emil, that's exactly what I said not to do.
But you know these guys, they're my friends. I didn't think you meant them. I'm sorry.
Don't tell me you're sorry. Tell them you're sorry.
Hey, is there a problem over here?
No, there is not. Wait here. It's locked.
Remy, what are you doing in here?
Yeah, okay, Emil shows up with... I said not to. I told him he goes and blabs to... Yeah, it's a disaster. Anyway, they're hungry, the food safe is locked, and I need the key.
They want you to steal food?
Yes. No, it's... No, oh, it's complicated. It's family. They don't have your ideals.
Ideals? If Chef Anson Pants had any ideals, you think it'd be hot to barbecue over here?
Microwave burrito?
Yeah, or toothpick and chicken. Out of French's corn dog. We're inventing new ways to sell out over here.
You'll be wanting some ideas by now.
I can never have to use my emails for any idea.
Shut up! I've got to think. Word's getting out if I can't keep them quiet. The entire clan's going to be after me with their mouths open. And here it is. Hey, your will. Oh, this is interesting. Mind if I...
Not at all. This used to be my office.
He's your son?
I have a son?
How could you not know this?
I am a figment of your imagination. You did not know. How could I?
Wait.
the truth? I am Ghost Gusteau's son. It's in my blood, I guess.
But you weren't aware of the fact until very recently.
No.
And it resulted in your taking ownership of this system. How did you find out?
Well, some part of me just knew. The Gusteau part.
Where do you get your inspiration?
Inspiration has many names. Mine is named Colette.
What?
Stuck in my teeth.
Yes, Inspector.
I wish to report a rat infestation. It's taken over my restaurant. The Gusteau's restaurant.
No, I cannot buy it. Let's see. First opening is 3 months.
What's happened now?
Monsieur, I have the information. Someone canceled. I'll start you in.
But the rat! You must see this stuff.
Past opening time.
Oh, he should have finished an hour ago.
Bonjour, ma chérie. Join us. We're just talking about my inspiration.
Yes, he calls it his tiny ship.
That dearest, I meant you.
You are Monsieur Linguine.
Oh, hello.
Pardon me for interrupting your premature celebration, but I thought it only fair to give you a sporting chance as you are new to this game.
Game?
Yes, and you'll be playing without an opponent, which is, as you may have guessed, against the rules.
Your anti-ego.
You're slow for someone in a fast lane.
And you're thin for someone who likes food.
I don't like food. I love it. If I don't love it, I don't swallow. I will return tomorrow night with high expectations. Pray you don't disappoint me.
Listen, we hate to be rude, but we're French. And
she meant to say it's dinner time and we're French. Look, you were distracting me in front of the press. How am I supposed to concentrate with you yanking on my hair all the time? And that's another thing. Your opinion isn't the only one that matters here. Colette knows how to cook too, you know. Ow! All right, that's it. Take a break, little chef. I'm not your puppet, and you're not my puppet-controlling guy.
What is the cook?
If I get your mind right, little chef. Ego is coming, and I need to focus.
You guy.
Wow. I have never seen that before.
Yeah, it's like you're his fluffy buddy or something.
I'm sorry, Remy. I know there are too many guys. I tried
what?
To limit.
It's okay. I've been selfish. You guys hungry? All right, dinner's on me. We'll go after lunch. In fact, tell Dad to bring the whole clan.
Little chef.
Oh, this is great.
It's a job, huh?
I see the appeal. Expected anything.
expects anything from me now is because of you. I haven't been fair to you. You've never failed me, and I should never forget that.
So, you have given up.
Why do you say that?
I know this sounds insane, but... Well, the truth sounds insane sometimes, but that doesn't mean it's not. The truth. And the truth is, I have no talent at all. But this brat, he's the one behind these recipes. He's the cook. The real cook. He's been hiding under my tofu. He's been controlling my actions. He's the reason I can cook the food that's exciting everyone. The reason Nico is outside that door. You've been giving me credit for his gift. I know it's a hard thing to believe, but hey, you believed I could cook, right? Look, this works. It's crazy, but it works. We can be the greatest restaurant in Paris, and this rat, this brilliant little chef, can lead us there. What do you say? You with me?
Keep
sure you won't deserve this, do you, Eagle?